My teacher passed out the all school riot, and it was whack.
You complaining? You complaining?
Yes, yeah.
Stop complaining about the all school riot. What's your problem with the all school riot?
The school riot is all whack.
It's whack? You say it's whack? Have you ever even done the all school riot?
Yes, I've done the all school riot. It's very whack.
Then you're wrong. Let's go. I'll teach you how to do the all school riot, and then you'll nail it, and then you'll see how fun it is. Let's go.
Okay, so the all school riot is pretty simple. This routine paragraph is pretty easy once you have some basic knowledge of it. The first part we need to do is read and analyze the prompt. So once you've read your prompt and the article, then you have your basic understanding of it. So you pretty much need to write down the topic, A meaning audience, and K meaning keywords. So once you read through it, what is the topic? The topics are dress codes and policies. And audience part, in my opinion, is always pretty simple. It's always either your school, your class, or your teacher. So, in our case, we'll be putting down myths, M, and English class. And finally, we get to keywords. Now this one can be a little confusing for some people. You just need to find the most important words and write them down. So again, for this, we'll be putting down dress codes and body shaming. Now, the next part is stop and think or review text. Now, some people, they usually forget what they're writing, so you can always just go back to your notes and read them again. It's like, okay, this is what I need to get back to. And then you have to go and brainstorm. So brainstorming is an important part of it because this is what gets you everything you need. This is all your evidence, all your sentences are based off of these. So first we're gonna write down,
I can't read.
Now we have to brainstorm or gather evidence. So what we can infer from this is, one of them is discrimination. And what goes with the discrimination? Well, of course it's harassment. What goes with harassment? Women's rights. What goes with women's rights? Shame. What goes with shame is biasness. And old rules. You don't need to fill out every topic line. You just need the words that will help you remember, this is what I need to write. So we move on to the next part. Now, once you get into this page, it's really imperative that you do this right. So you are in the planning stage, which is excruciatingly important. So you're gonna wanna write down what your topic is again. So we're just gonna go with dress codes and policies. Now, our big ideas for this topic, of course, will be dress codes and body shaming. Now, from our article right here, we'll have to read it again, unless you have memorized it, on what supports in this article dress codes or body shaming. And so we're going to go back in once we've read it. And some supporting details for dress codes is a girl in Wisconsin. Violates dress codes. Now, don't be ashamed of writing kind of the same piece of evidence twice. For example, for our next big idea, body shaming, we can write again, a girl in Wisconsin is body shamed. There's nothing wrong with using the same evidence twice as long as it's not exact. So, for the next part, we have our follow rule of five, yada yada, yada. Screw that. That doesn't concern you. Don't think about it. It's useless. Useless completely. It's retarded. There's no matter. Just don't think about it. It will just piss you off. So now we have to go into this next part, which is our topic sentences and conclusions. So you don't always have to start with SDS, which is simple declarative sentence. You can start with number sentence or any of the others. I'm just doing this in order to show you. So for our simple declarative sentence, we'll write young women are being body shamed. Now for our number sentence, we have to do something that's like numbers or a certain amount. So we can always just be a little simple, such as many women are discriminated against for what they wear. Now, for our quality question, you know, quality question can be really confusing for a lot of people. So, what it can really be is, our quality question is, what would sum up what we would ask a lot of this? What question summarizes your entire thing, your entire paragraph? So, what we can write down is, why do teachers feel the need to call students out on what they wear? For the situation stance, we just have to put our opinion on the matter. What is our stance on the situation?
What is your stance, Wesley?
My stance is, I don't believe that people should be against dress codes. They're there for a reason. So, let's write that down. Dress codes are there for a reason. Stop sexual harassment.
And now, we move on to the rough draft. If you don't know how to do the rough draft, what are you doing with your life? Do you even understand basic knowledge? Do you even understand the knowledge you are being bestowed? Thank God, we're finally almost done. So you can finally almost celebrate.
Almost.
Now, all we need to do is write our draft. Now, the draft is always very simple if you've gotten the rest of this done. All you need to do is go back, read a little bit, skim, like, yeah, that's right. And then, bam, we can do it. So, for our draft, we're always going to have to take a little look at our questions, or our topic sentences, and think about it. And then we turn it back to our draft. So what we write is about this. So, we're going to go with off our topics, our sentences. So,
say,